Geospatial analysis helps people to make better decisions. It doesn't make the decision for you, but it can help to answer critical questions. Tableau is such a flexible software that can take geospatial analysis to next level. Tableau released an awesome feature in its version 2020.4, which lets you add an unlimited number of layers to the map. This means you can visualize multiple sets of location data in context of one another, and there is no need for external tools to build custom background maps. So in this tutorial, I am going to show you how to use multiple map layers in Tableau for geospatial analysis. Having said that, let's get started. Welcome back, this is Gurpreet from DataWiz Canvas, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can spend less time preparing spatial dataset and more time analyzing your data with Tableau Multiple Map Layer drag and drop feature. In this tutorial, I'll be using sample superstore dataset, and getting started is really easy. Once you're connected to the sample superstore dataset, you simply create a base layer by bringing latitude and longitude into row and column shells. And once you brought it in there, you will see a map started to appear. And then in order to create colored layers on top of that, let's bring state into the mark shelf, and you will see all the states are plotted with a circle. But in this case, I want to have each state colored, so I will use the mark selection as a map, and you will see all the states are colored blue with a border on that. So let's change the color, and I will choose yellow in this case, and I will reduce the opacity to, let's say, 35-36, just so that I can clearly see what's in each layer. So once we have done that, adding the mark layers by dragging and dropping onto this map is really easy. So let's say first we want to bring all the cities onto this map on top of these states. So we will select city and try to drag it on top of the map, and you will see add to mask layer is popped up, and you bring on top of it and just leave it. And all the cities are populated on top of the state. And we can change the color again into the, or for each of these cities. And let's say I select black in this case and reduce the opacity a little bit. And you will notice that all of these city sizes same. But let's say I want to see the sales number in each of these cities. So I will simply bring the sales measure into the size shelf. And you will see all the cities which have maximum number of sales have a bigger circle. So let's do a bit of more formatting and increase the size a little bit further. And we have already reduced the opacity in this case, so let's increase a little bit, and we can see all of these cities with maximum number of sales. So like Seattle have 478 grand of sales, and if we hover over to this one, Los Angeles at 700 $3,000 of sales. And you can also zoom in, and if I want to zoom in to this section, I will simply go here, and you can also see other cities how their sales are affected. So that's about creating multiple layers. So you can create layer on top of each of these ones as well. So let's try another layer. Let's try to create postcode as another layer. So let's bring it on top of the map and add the marks layer and leave it. And you will see all the postcodes are created on top of each other in a different color. And you can again change the color coding of this one. And let's choose the red color in this scenario. And I want to create my own shape. So you can actually select shape marks, and you can decide the shape you want in this case. So let's say I want star in this case. So you can see now in a particular state, there are multiple cities with different sales, and each city have multiple postcodes. So let's zoom in again into this section, and you can see these are the different postcodes, and the Seattle as a total have that many sales. So all the people from these suburbs are doing sales. If we have a particular shopping center in this particular section, you can see and overlay the data on top of that. But that's not all. While allowing you to draw an unlimited number of customized map layers, there is a powerful capability on its own right. The multiple map layer feature in Tableau gives us even more tools than you can use to supercharge your analytics. So first up is the ability to toggle between the visibility of each layer. That's quite a powerful feature. So with this feature, you can actually decide to show or hide each layer at your own will, and allowing you to visualize only the relevant layer for the question in hand. So let me show you how it works. So let's go back to default view, and you can hover over to each of these marks, and you will see an eye icon on the left hand side. So this will let you control the layer visibility. So if I select this one for the state, you will see the state layer, the yellow color, disappeared. So if you just want to show the cities and postcodes, you can do it that way. Or let's say if I want to hide all the postcodes, so I will go to the postcode and click on the eye icon to hide all the postcodes. So that gives us more flexibility if we want to toggle between the visibility of each layer and we only want to visualize the relevant layers for our analysis. So sometimes you also want some of your layers to be interactive and the other remains just simply part of the background. So for example, if I hover over to these ones, you can see the state is highlighting and city when you click on the city. So it's city and state both are highlighting when we hover over to it. But let's say I don't want the states to be highlighted. I only want our cities to be highlighted when I hover over to them. So how we can do that? So on each of these marks, when you go hover over to these marks, you will see a drop-down icon there. And by clicking on that arrow, you can select the first option in the context menu is disable selection. So if you select that, it will disable the state layers. So whenever you hover over to that, it will not do anything. It is just using it as a background image. And when you are hovering over to the city, you can see all the tooltips and everything popping up. So that's how you can use the selection, and this will actually help you to create a dynamic background feature, and it will not produce any tooltips or other interactive element which is not required. So finally, you can also try to move the layers in terms of if you want the postcode at the bottom, you can simply select and drag it to the bottom of the layer. So you can, Tableau allows you the flexibility to move the layers, the order of layers between each other. You can either do it by dragging or dropping, or you can actually go here and say move up or move down. So this is all about multiple map layers in Tableau. And it's quite powerful in terms of all kind of our geospatial analysis, and we can achieve a lot more with this kind of feature. I hope you guys enjoyed this session, and if you have any questions, please feel free to drop me a message and I will get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you. See you next time.